Hey, good afternoon. Have you guys ever gotten that question like what stage you're in or wondered what stage cancer you have or family and friends are asking you that and you're not really sure how to respond because you don't really even know what it means? I know I had that same issue myself. I didn't understand what staging meant. So what does it mean? Well, here it is in regular guy terms. If you have cancer, you may be confused or overwhelmed a little bit when you hear your medical providers, doctors, and nurses talking about your disease using a formula of numbers and letters that really just don't make a whole lot of sense to you. And what that is that staging. Well, what does that mean? Well, this is what it is in regular guy terms. Is staging is used to determine how much cancer is in the body and where it's located. It describes how severe your cancer is based on the size of the original or your primary tumor, as well as the extent the cancer has spread in the body. So understanding the stage of cancer helps your doctors to develop a prognosis and design a treatment plan specifically for you for the patient. So just by saying Lee has throat cancer, we're going to do this, and this other person has throat cancer, we're going to do the exact same thing, doesn't really work. So staging helps the doctors put together a specific plan just for you based on your condition. So understanding the cancer stage is also critical to identifying clinical trials that may be appropriate for you and may be more helpful for you in the long run. Cancer is always referred to by the stage it was given at diagnosis, even if it gets worse or it spreads. So new information about how a cancer has changed over time is added to the original stage. So the stage doesn't change, even though the cancer itself might. So stage is determined by a combination of X-ray, CT, MRI, PET scans, and other tests and procedures. Cancer is also classified under the TNM staging system. That staging system was developed and maintained by the American Joint Committee on Cancer and the Union for International Cancer Control. This is the most commonly used staging and classification system used by doctors around the world. This means we can take this staging, go around the world, and other doctors know exactly what you had, what you have, and everyone can contribute because they're all in the same playbook. So there's basic staging categories. T describes the original or the primary tumor, such as T1 through T4, is the size or extent of the primary tumor. N describes whether or not the cancer has reached the lymph nodes, such as N1 to N3, the involvement of regional lymph nodes and the number or extent of the spread. M tells whether there are distant metastases. In other words, has the body spread to a distant part of the body, such as M0, which is no spread, and M1, which is spread. Sounds pretty simple. I know it. This right now, it sounds pretty simple. However, these are just the very basics of staging. The staging of cancer can be very complex and relies on data that we as the patient may not have access to or may not have seen and may not be able to correctly interpret. So if you look at these tables I've got here on the screen now, you'll see how these different basic parts of staging, these different categories, also spread out on their own as well. Staging provides a common language for doctors and nurses, etc., technicians, to effectively communicate with each other about a patient's cancer and to collaborate on the best course of treatment. Staging is not really designed for the patient. It's not designed for us to self-diagnose. It's not designed for us to determine our survivability or diagnose our treatments or anything like that because of our lack of training on this. So if you really want to know, if you want to know the details of your staging, talk to your medical provider, talk to your oncologist, and find out what your staging is, and then ask them how they came up with it. What does this specifically mean? And they can help explain and walk you through the process of how staging works. Your stage is not an automatic death sentence. Stage 2, 3, 4 does not mean the end, right? This is just a way for doctors to communicate about your particular cancer to coordinate your treatment. So, as always, everybody remain positive. Talk to you later. See ya.